Hi friends, welcome to GMK Tutorials. In this video, we will continue our discussion on canonical forms. So that is a part of the state space representation model. So canonical, so CCF and Chetam, that is nothing but controllable canonical form. So controllable canonical form, okay. So for that purpose, there is some transfer function is here that is equal to, let it be considered y by u is equal to some constant b into c2 s square c1 s c0 by s cube a2 s square a1 s plus a0 format. Okay. So this is a transfer function. Sir, how can we decide it is a transfer function? Basically, y is nothing but output, right? In case of a state space model, state equation is nothing but x dot is equal to a into x of t plus b into u of t, where u of t is nothing but input, x of t is nothing but a state variable. At the same time, y is equal to c into x of t plus b into u of t, input, state variable, output. Okay, so from this point of view, CCF is nothing but same analysis. You have to take order 3, x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot is equal to, now you have to represent A matrix. So as usual, previous case, so A value is equal to 0, 1, 0. So depending upon the, this is an order 3, therefore 3 cross 3 matrix, A value is equal to 3 cross 3 matrix. So 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so the last one is nothing but there is a confusion. Actually, in case of the differential equation, we will take the reverse order with negative sign. But in this case, you have to take the denominator value in the reverse order with a negative sign. So that is the only difference. Okay, denominator value with a negative sign, denominator coefficient with a negative sign. That is nothing but minus a0, minus a1, minus a2. That is the only difference. Next. Obviously, as usual, x1, x2, x3 plus B matrix. So, B matrix point of view, just you have to take this value. So, before of this one is equal to only B. So, remaining coefficient 0, 0, B into U only. Okay, that is for B matrix. At the same time, Y matrix, Y is equal to, so obviously, Y is nothing but a 1 cross 3. 1 row 3 columns, so 1 cross 3 matrix. So at the same time x1, x2, x3. Okay. Now in this point of view, so y matrix is nothing but, so for that purpose it is a row matrix, right? So there is some assumption. So in this case, what shall we do is nothing but, so whatever the numerator coefficient, take the numerator coefficients in reverse direction. Here we don't take any sign changes directly, whatever the sign is there, the same coefficients can be taken in the Y matrix. So that is nothing but C matrix point of view, that is nothing but C1, C0, C1, C2, that's it. So this is generally called as a CCF, controllable canonical form. Okay. So in the next one, in this case is nothing but OCF, observable canonical form. Okay, observable canonical form, that is nothing but OCF. So it is similar to, both are similar to same version. So general criteria is nothing but, just I will represent very short for x naught is equal to, actually in case of CCF point of CCF is equal to a into x of t plus b into u of t. At the same time y is equal to c into x of t plus d into u of t. So just I don't want to consider the d part because most of the cases d value may be 0. Okay, so just I will consider up to this one. So OCF is nothing but x dot is equal to, in case of OCF, A matrix is becomes as a transpose. A matrix is becomes as a transpose into x of t plus B matrix is becomes as a c transpose into u of t. At the same time, Y matrix, C value is becomes as a B transpose into X of. That is the only variation. In OCF, observable canonical form, A matrix is becomes as a A transpose, B matrix is becomes as a C transpose, C matrix becomes as a B transpose only. So if you want to represent the OCF, obviously you need to calculate CCF only. Without CCF, we don't get the value of A, B and C. So for that purpose, the matrix representation is nothing but x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot. That is equal to K transpose. Transpose means rows are becomes as a columns, columns as a becomes a rows. Therefore, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus A0, A1, A2. That is nothing but first case for matrix A. So second B matrix is nothing but, that is a transpose of C matrix. Transpose of C matrix is nothing but C matrix is a row matrix. This transpose becomes as a column matrix. Therefore, that is equal to C0, C1, C2 into U of T. At the same time, Y matrix is equal to, Y matrix is equal to, Y is equal to, so it is equal to B transpose. B matrix is actually column matrix. So it becomes as a transpose means a row matrix. Therefore, 0, 0, B into x1, x2, x3. So this is nothing but OCF, observable canonical form. Okay. So shortcut is ledu. Just if you know the CCF, you can directly represent the OCF. Here the conclusion is nothing but both CCF and OCF represents the same transfer function. Okay, both CCF and OCF represents the same transfer function. Ila chesna, it completely represents the e transfer function. That's why the state space models are not unique. Ante oka transfer function ki state space model okate untunda rule undi. Ila represent chesna same transfer function, ila chesna ante same transfer function. So that is one of the flexibility in case of the state space model compared to the transfer function. So basically transfer functional limitations is this transfer function is only applicable for SISO under single input, single output. But state space model is used for multi-input, multi-output case. That is one more advantage. Okay. So the calculation part is very easy in case of the state space model compared to the transfer function. Transfer function, the roots calculate chali, poles ekkada unnai, zero second, left side, right side, inni consideration chestunte gaani system stable and decide cheyali. But ikkada oka matrix lo unna dead value find out chesi system stable unstable decide cheyadaniki oka flexibility untundi. So that is the one assumption. Okay. Okay, so that is nothing but CCF. So next one, last one is nothing but we will take OCF model. Okay, I will continue with the lecture only. So for that purpose, so next one is nothing but diagonal canal. Diagonal canonical form. Okay, diagonal canonical form. So simply we can call as a DCF. Diagonal canonical form is simply called as a DCF. Okay, so DCF. So in this case, little bit same analysis point of view. So every transfer function in case of the YYU point of view, C2S square, C1S plus C0. Let it be take like this. Okay. At the same time, this transfer function, whatever we have, that is nothing but S cube. So first of all, you have to represent this complete denominator of the transfer function in terms of a poles and poles point of view. That means you have to calculate the roots of the transfer function. Therefore, obviously, roots is nothing but simply it's a poles of the transfer function, right? So for convenient point of view, S plus P1 is one root, S plus P2 is another root, S plus P3. So each transfer function
denominator on the roots ka divide chesi nee ila calculate cheyali. Obviously it is also equal to partial fraction method, so you have to represent again that is equal to k1 by s plus p1, k2 by s plus p2, plus k3 by s plus p3 format lo convert cheyali first. Okay, ee format lo convert chesin tarvata state space model start cheyali. So for that purpose as usual x1 x2 x3 dot is equal to basically we have to take a matrix 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. That pattern is not applicable here. The name itself diagonal canonical form. Diagonal means that only diagonal elements are present in this matrix. So that diagonal elements is nothing but poles of the corresponding system. That is nothing but minus p1 0 0 0 minus p2 0 0 0 minus p3. That is nothing but A matrix in case of DCF diagonal canonical form lo meer teeskuna ee poles evaithe untae poles anni diagonal lo form avutayi danne manam diagonal matrix ani cheptam mari ivanni as usual x1 x2 x0 plus B matrix. So B matrix check chestunnapudu obviously ikkada B undi, so B undi kaabatti obviously B lekapothe em saarante you will take as a one assumption, B le one assumption teeskondi. So 0 0 1, so manam teeskune reference idi kaabatti no coefficient, therefore you can take 1 ga consider cheyandi. So 0 0 1 into u. So konni cases lo deni u of t antam, u ani cheptam basically simplicity kosam u ani teeskuna it can be represented as u of t also, no issues. Okay, so that is nothing but first equation. Second equation is nothing but y matrix. So that is nothing but same as usual, y is equal to, so take the corresponding numerator coefficient in opposite direction. Therefore, that is equal to c naught c1 c into x1 x2 x3. So this is nothing but DCF, diagonal canonical form discuss చేసాము. So basically ఇలా చేసినప్పుడు ఇంకా కొన్ని అసంప్షన్స్ ఉన్నాయి. ఇది బేసిక్ గా మనం చేసే ప్యాటర్న్, బట్ కొంచెం మిస్టేక్ చేస్తున్నాం. ఇది బేసిక్ ఫార్మాట్. మరి బేసిక్ ఫార్మాట్ లో k1 వాల్యూ నీకు ఎక్కడ తెలుసా, ఇక్కడ k2 వాల్యూ తెలుసా, k3 వాల్యూ తెలుసా. సో ఫర్ దట్ పర్పస్ ఇక్కడ ఏం చేస్తాం అంటే ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ లైక్ దిస్ వి విల్ కన్సిడర్ సమ్ డమ్మీ వేరియబుల్స్ దట్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్, సో యు డోంట్ హావ్ ఎనీ వాల్యూస్. సో ఫర్ దట్ పర్పస్ ఐ విల్ అసంప్షన్ మైండ్ let it be take some numbers. Okay, so c1, okay, r1, like t1 as your wish, no issues. Okay, so c1 r1 t1, at the same time you have to take these values also with another numbers c2 r2 t2. Okay, okay, fine. Okay, you will take like this. Okay, now this c2 r2 t2 c1 r1 t1 represents only numbers only. Okay, so here assumption is nothing but here k1 is equal to c1 c2. Okay, so here k1 is equal to c1 c2, k2 is equal to r1 r2, k3 is equal to T1, T2. So that is the values of representation of that part. Okay. ఇక్కడ కన్ఫ్యూజన్ ఏం సార్, ఇలా చేశారంటే ఇక్కడ ఏం లేదు, ఈ ప్రోడక్ట్ చేస్తే ఓకే C1, C2 అంటే ఇక్కడ ఉండే C2 వాల్యూ కానీ ఇక్కడ మీరు తీసుకున్న C1 వాల్యూ రెండింటిని ప్రోడక్ట్ చేస్తే పార్షియల్ ఫ్రాక్షన్ చేసినప్పుడు మీకు K1 వాల్యూ ఎంత అయితే వస్తుందో ఆ వాల్యూకి మ్యాచ్ అవ్వాలి. దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ థింగ్. At the same time, k2 is equal to product of r1 and r2. K3 is equal to product of t1 and t2 that gives rise to k3 equal to r1. Okay, that is a basic assumption. So, for simplicity point of view, I will just take you one small example for this one. So I will take a small example for this one. So just we will take one small example, that is nothing but y by u is equal to 1 by s square s plus b. Okay, if you are taking this one, obviously we will take the roots, right? For this one, roots of this equation is equal to 1 by s plus 1 into s plus 3, right? The roots of this equation is equal to 1 by s plus 1 into s plus 3, right? If you are taking the partial fractions format, what is the partial fraction format? A, like in our pointer we will take k1, right? So k1 divided by s plus 1 plus k2 divided by s plus 2. I think, sorry, it is not s plus 3, it is s plus 2. Right? It is valid, right? S plus 2 is correct. 2s plus 3, right? What is the roots of this one? Minus b. S plus 1, s plus 2 is also valid. Square root of b square 4ac. Valid. 5s inner product is equal to external product. What is the value? Lambda s plus 3 is valid, right? S plus 3. Can you find the roots of this equation? Minus b plus or minus? Can you check it once? So 3 ones are 3. So 2, 1, s plus 1, s plus 2. There is a possibility. So we will take some roots point of view. Can you take any another equation? For convenient point of view, I will take one more equation, anything. So that is suitable for this one. S square 3s plus 2 is valid, right? S square 3s plus 2. Okay, 3s plus 2 is. So now in this case, we will get 1 by s plus 1, s plus 2. Okay, now we will take, this can be represented in the form of a k1 divided by s plus 1 plus k2 divided by s plus 2, partial fraction method. Now you have to find out the k1 value and k2 value. So whatever the methods you will know in conventional point of view, just I will follow the residue method. So residue method means, so k1 is equal to, so I need to find out the k1 value. So pole of this one, s plus 1, so total transfer function, s plus 1 into s plus 2, a s is equal to minus 1. Okay, take cancellation of this one. So therefore 1 by s is equal to minus 1. Minus 1 plus 2 is equal to, obviously 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. That means k1 is equal to 1 in this case. Right? One method. Okay. At the same time, k2 value is equal to. So k2 is equal to, in this case, 4 is the s plus 2. 1 by s plus 1. S plus 2 at s is equal to minus 2 case. So these two get cancelled. 1 by minus 2 plus 1, that is equal to 1 by minus 1, that is equal to minus 1, that is equal to k2 value is equal to minus 1. Okay, now you have to substitute those two values in this equation, then you will get that is equal to 1 by s plus 1 plus minus 1 by s plus 2. Okay. Minus 1 by s plus 2. Now you need to represent this equation in this form. So for that purpose, I will continue our discussion here. Just take this part in this direction. Okay. So what is the equation for this one? x1 dot, x2 dot, only second order equation only. Okay. Therefore, x1, x2 dot only. Why? Because the order of the differential equation is equal to only 2 only. Therefore, x1 dot and x2 dot only. Okay, A matrix is equal to, that represents the diagonal elements of the poles of the equation. Diagonal elements means, obviously, the poles of the equation. That is nothing but minus 1, minus 2. Therefore, minus 1, 0. Okay, 0, minus 2. So, that is the matrix of first one. Okay, next, x1, x2. Now in this case, this is important criteria. Okay. As per our analysis, we are assuming C1 R1 T1. So our intention is nothing but just write down this one only just for convenient point of y is equal to with x1 x2. So ikkada cheyalasindi entante manam in already discussion chesam c1 c2 is equal to k1 kavali. So that is nothing but in this case okay k1 only. So our upper analysis only k1 to two partial triangle. So c1 c2 that means k1 value is equal to 1 means both c1 and c2 values are 1, that is equal to k1 value, right? Why? Because k1 is equal to 1, the product of c1 c2 is also equal to 1, obviously it gives. But if you go for the k2 case, so k2 is equal to actually minus 1, that is equal to product of r1. 1 into minus 1 is also minus 1, 1 value gives. At the same time, minus 1 is equal to minus 1 into 1 is also minus 1. So there is a two possibilities are there. So for that purpose, first case is nothing but so 1 1, okay, 1 1. So next here c2 is equal to 1, r2 is equal to minus 1. This is a one possibility. Okay, another possibility is nothing but it is also represented as, if you are taking first one minus case, it becomes as a 1 minus 1 case. This is another possibility. Now it becomes another way, that is nothing but 1 1 case. So state space model is not unique, but until you తీసుకున్న వాల్యూ ఫస్ట్ వాల్యూ మైనస్ 1 తీసుకుంటే ఒక మ్యాట్రిక్స్ వస్తుంది, లేదు సెకండ్ వాల్యూ మైనస్ 1 ట్రేస్ చేస్తే అదర్ మ్యాట్రిక్స్ వస్తుంది. దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ డిసిఎఫ్, డయాగనల్ కెనానికల్ ఫామ్ అని చెప్తాం. ఇది ఓన్లీ వాల్యూ ఫర్, ఓకే, దిస్ మోడల్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ వాల్యూడ్, నో రిపీటెడ్ రూట్స్. ఓకేనా, మీరు తీసుకునే ఈ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఫంక్షన్ ఎక్కడ రిపీటెడ్ రూట్స్ ఉండకూడదు. ఓన్లీ దట్ మీన్స్ ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ ది పోల్ ఆర్ ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ ది రూట్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ 1 అయి ఉండాలి. అట్ దట్ టైమ్ ఓన్లీ ది డిసిఎఫ్ ఈస్ వ్యాలిడ్. సారీ, ఇన్ కేస్ ఇఫ్ ది రూట్స్ ఆర్ రిపీటెడ్ ఈస్ దర్ ఎనీ మెథడ్? ఆబ్వియస్లీ దర్ ఇస్ ఎ మెథడ్. దట్ మెథడ్ ఈస్ జనరల్లీ కాల్స్ ఏ జేసిఎఫ్, జార్డన్ కెనానికల్ ఫామ్ అని డిస్కస్ చేస్తాం మనం. సో ఇది ఓన్లీ ఒక రూట్ మాత్రం ఉంటే, అంటే రూట్ అనేది రిపీట్ కాకుండా ఉండాలి, అలాంటి టైంలో మాత్రమే ఈ డిసిఎఫ్ యూజ్ చేస్తాం. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ డయాగనల్ కెనానికల్ ఫామ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ 60-50% అయితే. ఓకేనా, ఒక జేసిఎఫ్ డిస్కస్ చేస్తే ఆల్మోస్ట్ 50+ అవుతుంది. ఇంకా రిమైనింగ్ ఏంటంటే స్టేట్ స్పేస్ రిప్రజెంటేషన్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఒకటి ఉంటాయి మనకి పెండింగ్ ఉండేది. సో నెక్స్ట్ కంట్రోలబిలిటీ అండ్ అబ్జర్వబిలిటీ ఎలా అనాలిసిస్ చేస్తాం, ఆ త్రీ టాపిక్స్ డిస్కస్ చేస్తే 6 యూనిట్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ కంప్లీట్ అవుతుంది. ఓకే, సో ఈ విల్ గో త్రూ ది ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఓకే, ఇన్ కేస్ ఇఫ్ యూ సో సేమ్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఫంక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్స్ మారుస్తాం అంతేనే. మనం జనరల్గా తీసుకున్నాం ఒకటి ఈక్వేషన్ తీసుకుంటే ఏమవుతుంది, C2 అంటాడు, C2 కింద కాన్స్టెంట్ తీసుకున్నాం 2 × s² + 1s + 5 అంటాడు. ఏదైతే నీకు ఎందుకు ఈక్వేషన్ ఫార్మాట్ s³ + 3s² + 2s + 1, ఇదే వాల్యూస్ తీసుకొని సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే ఫైనల్గా వచ్చేది అదే కదా మనకి ఎలా తీసుకున్నా కానీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద ఓన్లీ మెథడ్. మనకి కన్వెన్షన్ మెథడ్ ఎలా చేయాలో తెలిస్తే నెంబర్స్ మారుతాయి, మనం తీసుకున్న వేరియబుల్స్ తీసుకున్నా ఈక్వేషన్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ లేదు ప్రాబ్లమ్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ జస్ట్ నెంబర్స్ ఆర్ బి వేరియబుల్స్ ఆర్ రీప్లేస్ విత్ ఓన్లీ నెంబర్స్. దట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ సిసిఎఫ్, ఓసిఎఫ్ అండ్ డిసిఎఫ్. ఓకేనా.